Yesu. Asante sana Yesu moyoni. Asante sana Yesu moyoni.
Hakuna kama wewe.
Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe moyoni.
Mwangu.
Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe. Hakuna kama wewe moyoni.
Wewe ni nguvu yetu.
Wewe ni nguvu yetu. Wewe ni nguvu yetu moyoni.
Oh, do Father. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Master.
Oh,
unastahili kuabudiwa, unastahili ewe Bwana, unastahili kuabudiwa, unastahili. Ni nani kama wewe, unastahili kuabudiwa, unastahili wewe, unastahili. Hakuna kama wewe,
unastahili kuwa,
unastahili wewe,
unastahili wewe
Bwana, unastahili kuwa, unastahili wewe,
unastahili.
Hakuna kama wewe,
unastahili kuwa,
unastahili wewe,
unastahili wewe Yesu, unastahili kuwa,
unastahili wewe.
Unastahili we,
unastahili kuinuliwa,
unastahili ewe Bwana,
unastahili kuabudiwa, unastahili we, unastahili kuabudiwa,
unastahili ewe
Bwana, unastahili kuabudiwa, unastahili we. Hakuna Mungu kama wewe.
Baba, katika jina la mwanao Yesu Kristu, tumekuja miguuni mwako baba wetu asubuhi ya leo. Tunashukurani tele mbele zako baba, ni kwa sababu ya mipango yako ambayo Mungu wetu umeipanga siku hii ya leo. Tunakushukuru Mungu ni kwa sababu ya kutujalia kila mmoja kuingia katika nyumba hili ambayo imeitanishwa na jina lako. Asante baba, ni kwa sababu ya dhabihu ambayo umeiandaa siku hii ya leo, ni kwa sababu ya roho zetu Mungu wetu. Tunakushukuru baba tukisema hakuna Mungu mwingine kama wewe. Tunakuabudu Mungu wetu asubuhi ya leo tukijua baba wetu wewe ndio kimbilio letu, wewe ndio ngome letu Mungu wetu. Asante baba ni kwa sababu ya kutujalia Mungu wetu kuona siku hii ya leo. Hatusemi ni jambo la kawaida Mungu, lakini umegharimu mkono wako. Hivyo baba tunakupa sifa na shukrani ni kwa sababu ni zako. Asante Mungu ni kwa sababu wa upendo wa ajabu kutoka msalabani Mungu wetu. Asante siku hii ya leo baba wetu, tunaomba ukaweze kutunenea kwa njia ajabu baba wetu. Neno ambalo utakuwa ukuja siku hii ya leo, hebu litoke baba wetu kutoka kinywa chako. Wewe ni Mungu mkuu na hakuna Mungu mwingine kama wewe. Ambao bado wako njiani baba, tunaomba ukaweze kuharakisha ili unapotubariki utubariki pamoja. Asante baba ni kwa sababu ya nafasi ambayo imepita, bado Mungu tunahitaji uwe pamoja nasi kwa nafasi ambayo imesalia Mungu wetu. Asante ni kwa sababu ya baraka za kipekee baba wetu ambao unatubariki nazo siku hii ya leo. Unastahili Mungu wetu. Tunakuinua baba na tunakuabudu ni kwa sababu wewe ni Mungu na hakuna Mungu mwingine kama wewe. Baba endelea kutuonekania Mungu wetu. Hebu roho wako mtakatifu akapenye ndani yetu baba wetu. Hebu roho uwepo roho wako ukae katika kikao hiki. Asante baba ni kwa sababu wewe ni Mungu. Tunaomba tukijua ya kwamba baba umetusikiza na utaendelea kutusikiza ni kwa sababu wewe ni Mungu. Na ni katika jina la Yesu Kristu aliye Bwana na Mwokozi wetu.
Amen. Bwana asifiwe. Hatujamaliza, tafadhali tusimame tuimbe vyo moja zuri ili tuweze kuingia the next stage.
Tuli magatiga
baudo manene magatiga mbote magukeme
go to Adimae
Thaini ware tuare a Jesu Kristo ne twenyihia hare we tugikuhoya utuikurukirie kirathimo ne twenyihia magoro ine maku tugikuhoya waranirie na ithwe Jehova ducerere tondu we ngai Jehova twe haha gikaro gikitone ni tufatairio ni we Jehova ni tufatairio ni tha ciaku Jehova ni tufatairio ni hinya waku Jehova Baba wito mwathani twakuhoya turi ngwatanira na turi meciria mamwe thaini ware tuare a Jesu Kristo Toge kuhoya tene tofatareti onewe Jehova. Mwadhani turathime. Tosherere tondu we ngai. Tugarure meciria Jehova Baba wito. Twake mwako mweru Jehova Baba wito. Mwadhani to lift you from this glory to a higher glory. In the name of our Lord Jesus. We surrender. We submit ourselves unto you. We glorify you because you are Lord. Gotire kayo gyohana tawe. Igoro nathe koyoira riri waku Jehovah, more than yoka or intercede on behalf of your nation, Jehovah. More than you to reha hatoroga meta igororia fororio, Jehovah. Tondo tuereta koreato kinyideti ya makinya maito. Ateneto inheriteta muda makiwakele kanero. We are inheritor of this nation by your grace, Jehovah. We are inheritor of this nation because that is your promise to Abraham, O Heavenly Father, our Father. We thank you because we owe nobody, Jehovah. But we owe unto you everything, O King of Glory. More than it wakuhoya favor, Jehovah. Madhyororo kama maodo mwade. Maria mareke kaforolio, Jehovah. More than it visit yadu waku, Jehovah. Todwa narelia favor wito shianashia kushare misri, Jehovah. Ona maodo marito meke ka, Jehovah. Goshe ni gotirio dogu wake karamuza maki wakele kanero. Na idweka iwakele kanero. We are the chosen nation. And we are standing in Goshe, O Heavenly Father. Father, tuetere ire ngai wakele kanero inya waku na authority yaku Jehovah ne twagotea na ne twakwambararia na ne twakwenda na twauga we ngai Jehovah gikaro gike ne giaku Jehovah nathima turathima ithwe ciana ciaku Jehovah toririkane na iririkana ria tha Jehovah everything that we do let it exalt on your name Jehovah undu wathe ukugathereria nja kiugo giaku Jehovah ne twaregana naguo theine wa Tuare a Jesu Kristo Tuatia hinya waku Jehovah Tosherele todo we gai Oka weka wega mudha maki wakile kanero Thank you gai We surrender totally unto your authority Haha ni ohohora na giru woko obo Jehovah Uri amoru alu niye kuhona Jehovah Uri avava witu wagete hinya ni okomwekira hinya Jehovah In a captivity Jehovah You are sending us free O Heavenly Father By the blood of Jesus We surrender all unto you Jehovah Mwathani toigwere tha no tucerere Jehova na ni theini wari twari yaku na ria moroguo na ria roho mutheru twahoya na twacokia ngatho Amen Amen Bwana asifiwe Mwathani agocwo ni hinda rega ona ria gucokeria ngai ngatho ni mawiko make tutikonage ati maundu mothe ta marekika hatari na gitumi urerwo we niwe urugamite haria hari haku Ati orogame haria hari haku nigetha one the deliverance of the Lord Ati gorogama haria hega nigetha Jehovah eke odo na ajaririe I don't know where you are standing You might be standing outside the grace of God Mwathani aratira tuikare wega ini wake nigetha a intervene na twaririe mwathani aheo goshi ihinda rere ngwenda kuhe mundu wina undu angitwira any encouraging word kana ona testimony ni ihinda rega na mwathani amurathime karibuni
Bwana asifiwe naitwa Elizabeth Nyambura nimeokoka nampenda Yesu Bwana wabariki
atawale Atawale tu, mochie Yesu, atawale. Nyumbani zetu, atawale tu, mochie Yesu, atawale. Atawale, atawale tu, mochie Yesu, atawale. Watoto wetu, atawale tu, Mwambie Yesu atawale 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 tu Mwachie Yesu atawale 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 tu Mwachie Yesu atawale 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 tu Mwachie Yesu atawale Tembea na Yesu Amen Tembea na Yesu Tembea na Yesu Amen Hallelujah Tembea na Yesu Tembea na Yesu Tembea na Yesu Amen Hallelujah Ukiwa nyumbani Ukiwa kanisani we, tembea na Yesu, amen, hallelujah. Tembea na Yesu, tembea na Yesu we, tembea na Yesu, amen, hallelujah, amen.
Na pia aombe sadaka.
Mother ni draucho kalia gado ona rege hidalere because of the children that you have given us my father in these prayers want to honor your name my heavenly king because of your goodness and your kindness my father to each and every family here Shanaishi mwathani utuhete igatuika kirathimo na ikahana mahoa thini witu mwathani want to thank you again because of them my heavenly father twedu nogayone kuironi wega mwathani wanachokeri ugatho kumbarira maciarirwo mwathani ona mahinda ma we want to thank you because of them even committing their lives unto you O Lord so that you guide them and lead them my father in all the days of their own lives na nigetha makure no horo wa gugwitigira no horo wa gukwenda ngai thitu makwirireirie we are committing them unto you my heavenly father even as they go for the Sunday school this morning My Father, this day shall be a blessing unto them, my Father. Even as they grow, my Father, in the knowledge of your word, mwathani makure mamenyete weyu na mamenyete yohana atia mwathani. We want to thank you because of them, because you're going to guide them and lead them this day, my Father. Because this day is going to make a difference because of the word that you're going to hear, my Father. We want to thank and glorify your holy name because of them. Noega mwathani tonigutweka wega. Again, my Father, I want to thank you because of the offerings that you have given this morning, O Lord. Mudo owo the gaithe itu arutete na kuyedera. Because we need a blessing, my heavenly Father. Troka mwathani tukaruta as a sacrifice before you, O Lord. Tukimenyaga ati ona kwirutira gwitu na igongona riega tugikogwo na ngoro theru mwathani. We commit these offerings unto you, my Father, again. Na nigetha ituike cia gukuruta wira waku mwathani ngai thitu maundu mara magirire ngai. Above all, nitukuhoya mwathani mbeca ici ituike ati nigutuma andu aingi mume kwa ngoma mwathani. Mwathani mamenye uhoro wa ma ngai the witu. Mamenyane nawe. Ngai thitu toru indo citu ni citu mwathani ngai thitu na atuguria hamwe na indo citu na nikio thakame iria mwathani atuguria gitutaithia na gituhe mwathani wendo wa kuheanaga uguo no guturahwa thakame tabruke mwathani githe kinyire na andu matari akumenya ni munio matari makumenya ni ndu akiria tuheanite ni turaucokeria ngatho because is going to do the work of the ministry my father for the glory of your holy name we want to thank you because of every giver my father this morning even those people who never gave my father because they didn't have anything to give bless their pocket even bless their hands, my Lord, so that next time they'll become a blessing, O Lord. Na nimega da magatiyo kamwa dani akura di maneli hamu eva ba gai nari agi gai niudo idu ramaru tete.
Mariaga. Tuna dugata ya gai kikaroge kiki.
Tuko na mtumishi wa Bwana katika kikao hiki. Ni mmoja wa wale ambao wamefanya kazi kubwa sana siku ya leo. Tusipomuinua wakati kama huu hata tumpatie nafasi ya kusalimia. Ni mmoja wa wale ambao wamefanya kazi kubwa sana ya Bwana. I'm going to call Bishop Dale. He's here with his own wife. Utusalimie tu.
Bwana asifiwe. Haleluya. Tugeza ndio huo. Bonde mtumi yako ha?
Huu ndio bibi yake.
Mtugeti ni netoi na matukumba ige.
Tunajua na mchugaze hapa kwa siku kadhaa
na sorry to kago mama huko.
Tulikuwa hapa ni ayati tulikuwa kuja pa kwa kuabudu hapa.
Sasa ukwera.
Siku hatukutaka kukuambia
we
just wanted just to have a service here then we go somewhere else for another ceremony. That was our plan with the whole of my family. We never came with all of them. Only one of them brought us here. Just stand us and say hi. Even you with your daughter there. That's the last born, our last born. Even the daughter there. We are okay. We love you all very much. That's why we say we're not going to tell you, Pastor. You should not change your program in any way. We'll be here, just sit down and even listen to the song. We'll come another day just to preach. We'll give you the word. Even when you have your own message, and the Lord is going to bless you. I'm happy this day, even today, you are saying the Lord is Lord. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, just wake up. You lift up the work of the Lord inside yourself, even the other people, and God is going to bless you. Every day when you lift up, you just lift up the work of the Lord. You wake yourself up and you lift up the work of the Lord, and the Lord, he's going to lift you up. Even when the other was sleeping, God is going to lift you. God bless you. What do you say? Praise the Lord. Just say in the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. He's my husband. And I love the Lord. I love him. He saved me when I never knew who I was. Since that day, the hope is still in me. I have never stopped it just like a coward. I always proclaim Jesus, and he has been with me. Praise the Lord. I love the Lord. I like the Lord. Being in this place, it's my desire every day to come here to be with you. Every day. Every day. I want to be here. When I was coming, I always tell the Lord, I wanted to come and fast with them.
Yep.
Praise the Lord. I thank the Lord. All things work together for good. Thank Lord for coming here. I love you. I've been here before.
And last time, Mutoria gai. Ni juga katoria ada ujui gide.
Wamefanya kazi kubwa sana ya Bwana in the Republic of Kenya. They have gone through a rough time. But the Lord has kept them well and safe. Praise the Lord. We are here because of such people, because of the word that they taught us. They gave us a firm foundation in salvation, and that's why we just remain like that. Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, this day I want just to talk about a few things, and if we don't finish today, we do it next time. I want just to talk about the tongue. There's someone who sang a song and said, I don't know how he's going to sing in English, but I'm going to sing.
Aduria amwe paragia ndeto koro inesia omena muku okenane are amaragia ndeto mena wega wagai kadi shokreto atumia ayetu.
It talks about the little women, young ladies,
maragia ndeto koro inesia omena muku.
They talk about just their own songs when they are just bitter in their own souls,
not what they are agia new kolio,
and everything that you talk about you have to give an account when you meet just in the great gathering with God. Therefore, brother and sister, today I want us just to talk about the tongue. We're going to talk more about that. The Bible says that the tongue has the power to give you good things and even bad things. The things that you talk about, sister, with your own tongue, they can take a time that they lead you just to evil or even to a blessing. And it's always good to be careful as a child of God every time you speak. May the Lord help us. And that's why we have 2 ears and the mouth is only one. So that the ears can hear, but the tongue should not be talking everything. Let us read the word of the Lord. In the book of James, James chapter 1. James chapter 1 or 2?
James 3. James 3, sorry. Kultiemwe, Ginyakeda.
James chapter 3, 1 all the way up to 9. My brethren, let not many of you become teachers, knowing that we shall receive a stricter judgment. For we all stumble in many things. If anyone does not stumble in word, he is a perfect man, able also to bridle the whole body. Indeed, we put bits in horses' mouths that they may obey us, and we turn their whole body. Look also at the sheep. Although they are so large and are driven by fierce winds, they are turned by a very small rudder wherever the pilot desires. Even so, the tongue is a little member and boasts great things. See how great a forest a little fire kindles, and the tongue is a fire, a word of iniquity. The tongue is so set among our members that it defiles the whole body and sets on fire the course of nature, and it is set on fire by hell. For every kind of beast and every and bird and reptile and creature of the sea is tamed and has been tamed by mankind, but no man can tame the tongue. It is an unruly evil, full of deadly poison. With it we bless our Lord and Father, and with it we curse men, who have been made in the similitude of God. Out of the same mouth proceeded blessings and cursing. My brethren, these things ought not to be so. Does a spring send forth fresh water and bitter from the same opening? Can a fig tree, my brethren, bear olives, or grapevines bear figs? Thus, no spring yields both salt and water and fresh. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you and even lift you high. Even this time, as we proceed to hear your word, the word that you told the devil that every word of the Lord shall make you have someone alive. Help us this day. Even if the word enters our hearts, it's going to be a help to in our own lives. We honor you and even lift you because you are a good God. Amen. This time as we talk about the tongue, the Bible says, just in the verse 1, says we should be very careful not to be so many teachers. And the reason why it was told that we should not be so many teachers, because there are some things, brother and sister, you can even teach some things from your mouth which can be a problem in your own life. And everything we always teach using our own tongue. I'm talking because of the tongue. If I never had a tongue, I could not speak. I'm teaching you today because I have a tongue. And that's why I'm talking. And that's why the Bible says you should not be so many teachers. It's always good as a man of God or a child of God to be careful. Even if you're teaching someone, you should know what you're teaching them. Sometimes we sit down with somebody, someone seeking help. We just need just to talk. But I always tell the Lord to help me, so that whatever I'm teaching that person, so that I'm not misleading this person, but shall be helping that person's life. I'm always careful, brothers and sisters. Everything that I stand here to teach and even to talk is something that comes from the Lord. So many people have gone astray. Even some others might have gone astray because of the teaching that they have been given. Therefore, brother and sister, even it's always good as a man of God, as a child of God, before you teach, you should know and even know for sure what you're talking. And even pray for the Holy Spirit to lead you and guide you, so that you know what you're doing and even what you're teaching. And there the word of the Lord says, we always just give, we bring those just into the cows. And we can lead them wherever they go. In the same way, we should guide our own tongues. And a week ago, this week, someone called me. He was so bitter in his heart. And he's so bitter because of a pastor, of the words that the pastor told him. And he's decided, I have to go and talk to that pastor. The only satisfaction I could get is only to go and tell him that you are wrong. But I, But I told him, my sister that I tell you in the name of Jesus Christ. Don't even go and ask him. But praise the Lord so that he can help you. Praise the Lord. And she called me yesterday. And she told me that I'm in peace. May the Lord help us even we as children of God. The Bible says we are more judged than even them. Whosoever shall lead astray one of these that the Lord has chosen, he will just be put in the bottomless pit. Therefore, brother and sister, we should be very careful as children of God so that we don't lead you astray. If she came to me and I tell her, no, he was not supposed to tell you that, go and tell him and just give him a lesson, she would have done the same. But I told my tongue that you have to help me what she's going to talk. Don't even talk to him, just keep quiet. May the Lord help us. Brother and sister, we have a problem with the tongue, a problem that brings so many problems to other people. It can destroy a house which has a foundation, a husband and wife living for many years. A day comes within 10 minutes something came from the tongue and had destroyed the whole of that household. And therefore, brother and sister, you should be very careful when you're speaking. If you want to say something, it's always good to speak because you cannot just be dumb. But not every talk which is helpful. I'm not telling you not to speak or say, but I'm telling you before you speak and even as you speak, you should think what you're talking about. Now, what am I going to say? May the Lord help us. Praise the Lord. Some people who have families, if it comes a time you tell your wife that I love you, it's very hard for a woman just to tell them. It's very hard for a husband or a wife to say, if you tell all the mamas from home,
I love you too. I love you too.
They always say that I love you. You go there to your nanny. That word that I love you, it does a lot of work. If you continually tell your wife that I love you, and you tell her that you're a wonderful woman and you're a great woman, she gets even more. She becomes more glorious and even gains more days. And when she's glorious to you, and when she's happy, it's also a husband's joy. May the Lord help us. It's always good as a husband. It comes a time when the words are coming from your own mouth concerning your wife. You're just praising her and even lifting her up. And just
how
that. Don't make yourself stiff neck. Just make her straight. Praise the Lord. When you tell her that you love her and she's a great woman, she does not mean that you become her slave, but you're building up your own house. Therefore, brothers and sisters, may the Lord help us. The things that are coming from your own mouth issues that are able to build our own life. You tell your tongue even when you're speaking something, it is an issue that is going to build your house. So many households have run astray because of the tongue. Even you as a as a wife. Sometimes tell your wife good things. Praise the Lord. I am always happy because my wife is always there. She never takes me down. And I become encouraged even to do what I'm doing. And that is something which is very important. May the Lord help us, brothers and sisters. Try to be speaking good things about your husband. Even if you're not used to that, just say, oh, I love you too. You're a great man. We are always happy of what you do. We are happy because of the way you have brought up your children. You're a great man. I always get text message from my own children.
You are the best dad.
Not only just on a talking, you can even write something in as a text. You are a great father. When they tell me that, the whole of that week I'm uplifted.
Praise the Lord.
Everybody wants to be lifted up. Praise the Lord. When my wife tells me you are a great man, wonderful man, you are such a wonderful man, I am always encouraged. And I feel that I'm also like other men. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Therefore, brothers and sisters, let us tell our tongues to help us the things that we are talking. Because brothers and sisters, the issues and the things that you can talk about today, you can destroy so many things in life. And I can even come and tell pastor an issue, a bad thing, and I tell him what I want to tell him, and he get bitter with that, and then I walk away. Once I go away, and I find that I misled or I did the wrong thing, because it's my tongue which went astray, I come to him and tell him, just forgive me. Yes, he has forgiven me, but there's a scar that has poured in his own heart, and scars are always there. You always be seeing that scar. May the Lord help us. There's someone who just gave a false testimony on against a preacher. He talked about something which was not true. When he just said the wrong thing and stayed for a long time, it was a tongue that talked about that. And he told the preacher, just forgive me. And he said, I forgive you what you did. But there's something that I want you to do. And he just went to the feathers of the chicken feathers. He went just to the chicken where they just slaughtered. And he put them in a bag. Because he was a rich person. And I want to take you all these feathers. And you just scatter them. You scatter all of them. After you scatter them, you come back here. He went and scattered all of them. And I tell you, wherever you scattered all the feathers, go and take them one after the other and put them in the bag. And when he was thinking of what he's going to do, and he told me, I cannot do it. Because some of them were blown by the wind, and he told me, that's what you did. You talk about the issue, that thing is gone, and people has gone to their ears, this thing you cannot get rid away from it. And that's what, brother and sister, when you open your mouth and say something, that's the way the tongue works. And it's always good, brother and sister, ask the Lord to help you even when you're speaking. May the Lord help us. We tie our tongues. you look for firewood just to burn your own tongue. Before you speak and say anything, tell the Lord to help you. It's better off for you to keep quiet. Because brothers and sisters, it can, might come a time. This church has been there for a long time. We started this church in 2000. It might even come one day. Someone just come with an issue and just finish the whole of this church. That's why may the Lord help us. And in the same way, brother and sister, some of the issues that we speak, there can be a problem even in your own life, thinking that you just
thought.
When the children of Israel came from Egypt, they came all the way along and they passed the Red Sea. And they were on the way just to the Canaan. And they started, they opened their mouth and started talking. They talked so many evil things that the Lord became angry with them because of their tongues and their mouths. All those, the older generation, no one entered there. It's only Joshua and Caleb. And that was as a result of the tongue. And just when they were just walking by in the journey, the wilderness, Moses said, I won't stay like that again. Sometimes polygamy had no problem that time. And she went and just a Cushanite woman. And when she he married a Cushanite woman, her elder sister, then you knew Miriam is the one who brought Moses up when just he was in the riverbed so that he's not killed. And he found whatsoever my brother has done is not the right thing. And for sure, whatever he did was not right because he could not marry someone from their own tribe. It was just something which was not right. But she started complaining. She opened her mouth and started talking about their brother Moses. And started saying, the Lord only talk with Moses? And the Lord got angry because of the words that came from Miriam. And she became sick with leprosy. And she was thrown away out of the city for 7 days because of her tongue. Therefore, brother and sister, the only thing I beseech you and even tell you is always good as a person of God, a child of God, just before you open your mouth, tell the Lord to help you. Praise the Lord. Some things come which are difficult and which are problematic in the house of the Lord. But tell the Lord to help you. Tell the Lord, I want your help, Lord. Yes, these things are so burdensome to me. Things have gone this way and that way. But I pray you that, Lord, you help me. You have 2 years and you're going to hear so many things. But whatever you're going to tell to speak, you should tell the Lord to help you. Praise the Lord. I know I'm not saying that you should just keep quiet on everything. The tongue is the one that we praise the Lord. Now we praise the Lord and lift Him high. And He was happy in heaven. Because the Bible says the Lord accepts the praises of His own people. He is happy when He's up there because of our tongues. We just came and prayed. We told Him whatever we wanted to tell Him with our own tongues. May the Lord help us. It has come a time, brothers and sisters, so many people have gone astray or become just disoriented because of their own tongues. So even the pastors and the preachers, they become issues with which are not good. We just give wrong doctrines because of our own tongues. May the Lord help us. If you have nothing to say, you'd rather be quiet. It's better, Lord, if you keep quiet. Praise the Lord. Even your own children, brother and sister, try to be talking good things about your own children. Tell them that I love you. Praise the Lord. Tell them that they are wonderful children. And the more you are telling their children good things, God is seeing from above because the tongue has the power. And all of the time you call your children ngombe, you have a problem. And you know that a cow will always be a cow. You're also a big cow. If you call your child a cow, when you tell your child is stupid, you're also stupid. Be careful. May the Lord help us. The things that you're talking with your own tongues, there's a problem. And you can get problems in your own life. You might even get reproached within your own life. So you spoil your things because of your own tongue. Let me tell you that, brothers and sisters. And these are the last days that the Bible says that people will just start their own preachers, giving them and talking to them the things that pleases their own souls. I will not be talking to you the things that you feel that they are pleasing to you, but I want to talk to you about the issues that are helpful to you. Brothers and sisters, if you have nothing to say, just keep quiet. May the Lord help us. Anything that you can spoil, tell the Lord to help you. May the Lord help us. Some things have gone wrong.
President candidate.
We had one of the presidential candidates was very high in points. I don't even know where he's going now.
Donald Trump.
Because of his own tongue. He talks whatever he wants to speak. And I wonder, what is he talking about? And you wonder, what is he talking? He's going all the way down. May the Lord help us. He was just all the way up there. He has gone all the way down. In the same way, the spiritual life is the same way. The Lord can lift you high, and even drop you all the way down. May the Lord help us. Even the prayers that you're praying, before you pray, you should know what you're talking to the Lord. And the Lord looks at you and says, what is this person talking about? Sometimes I'm praying prayers, but I'm cursing someone. The Lord will never hear such prayers. And therefore, may the Lord help us. Before you open your mouth even to pray, know what you're going to tell the Lord. May the Lord help us. If an ordinary man can tame the horse, which is something big, and he just only put the kindle just in the tongue, and he can turn the horse to wherever he wants to turn it. Why should you do the same? Why shouldn't you do the same to your tongue? So that you can take it the way you should. Tell the Lord to help you. My sister, tell the Lord to help you. So that you can know what you're saying. You'd rather keep quiet instead of speaking the wrong thing. Because brothers and sisters, we can gossip just with the same tongue. We do this and that with the tongue.
The tongue
even just brings so many people down, talking evil about that person. I cannot speak anything good about you. I always talk about the even the bad thing about that person. May the Lord help us. Praise the Lord. Always talk good of someone. Talk about the goodness of your pastor. You have got good pastors. Even when every time you talk about it, say that we become encouraged. But if you start from here all the way up to home, you are talking evil about your pastor. You sit down with the children talking about your pastor. There are some parents who are talking about their pastor. The children were there. And one of the father was saying that our pastor has got two mouths. Two mouths.
The pastor has two mouths. Do you know what does that mean? No, you don't know, eh?
Vinywa viwili, umoja hapa na hapa. Kama giant.
Eh? Unajua hiyo ni nini? Yeah, udaku, yeah. Mwadhani ya goshu.
Pwe bwana sipe sana.
Asiyari magidi magikarathi.
They were just sitting down there.
Na mudhuri na siyana.
A husband and the wife and the children.
Makiabeli ya kwa lihoro wa pastor mtu.
They were talking about the pastor when the children were there.
Makiabeli ya kwa pastor wano amen. Pastor shino amen wa
hii. And they were talking about that pastor has two mouths. One side and one side.
Mwanani ya igua.
And the child heard about that.
Ate pastor wa yetu nungato igana.
And the pastor has two mouths.
Na mwana doi menu wa hii ni ki.
And the child does not know the meaning of two mouths.
Na pastor kiri ya kwao.
When the pastor came to visit them.
Mwanaki ya beja kudhiro uka pastor.
The child was going around the pastor.
And the child was going around
the pastor. He couldn't understand what is going wrong. And he asked, he took the child and asked the child, what's wrong with you?
Pastor, he was very innocent. Pastor, very innocent.
Both of them were very innocent.
Pastor.
The pastor and the child are innocent people.
Pastor,
and he asked the child, what's wrong with you, my baby, my friend? I had my dad and mom saying that you have got two mouths. I'm looking for the two mouths. Where is the other mouth? It came as a result of the tongue. The pastor knew exactly what they were talking about, but the child, and he knew what they were talking. And it's the same way, brothers and sisters. Even your children, when they are there, be careful what you speak. Don't be arguing when the children are there. Some of the difficult things, just control yourself when the children are there. Just control your tongue. Even when someone wrongs you, be careful. May the Lord help us. If at all there is a bad thing that the child gets hold of, when the child is small, all the way up to 9 years, the only thing that the child listens, gets, the child never forgets. And that's the best place to teach a child. You think that the child is not hearing, but the child is hearing. You should be very careful. When you're speaking or saying anything in front of a child, because the child catches and holds everything slowly by slowly, and the child becomes spoiled. You see that your child has become spoiled, but it all began when the child was young. All the way from 5 months up to 9 years. Everything that the child hears, they always remember. And remember, I was just in a Catholic church. The things that I was taught, I still remember them. Because I was taught when I was young. I was just going for just for communion when I was young. Some of the things are still in my own mind. Therefore, you should be very careful. Anything that is coming from your mouth, may the Lord help us. Because you have just done so many evils because of our own tongues. Even when you're speaking to your child, you should choose and know the words that you're speaking to your child. When you're opening your mouth, know what you're talking with your child. Because your child can become spoiled. May the Lord help us. Tell your children, your wonderful children, your wonderful children. May the Lord help us. Do you know why the children have run astray in this country? I've seen so many weddings. They're having the wedding cards.
No kids.
They say kwa harusi nyingi wanasema watoto hawezi kaenda huko na siwe si nikaenda kwa hiyo harusi.
No kids. Mahiki megeri kwa marandiko.
Wanaandika hivyo.
Adogathie na mwana kwa no agire gogithio hiki.
You cannot go with your child in that wedding. There was another wedding yesterday where they walikuwa wamesema watoto wasiende kwa hiyo harusi.
Na bibi roiga ako
If your wedding you said no kids should come, you should pray about your kids also. May the Lord help us. Because the Bible says this kingdom belongs to us and our children. The kingdom that I belong to belongs to me and even my children. Wherever I am, I should pray that my child should be there also. May the Lord help us. This kingdom belongs to us and even our own children. And the reason why they're saying, because the child be brought up just like a cartoon from the TV, you all just keep the gift, the card, the kid on the TV.
Manke George. Eh? Curious George. Manoshi ayo domi dio no.
The child, the teacher becomes Curious George, the cartoonist.
And
for the child to grow up and even know that, that's not the way we talk. All the time we go to a wedding, you're told no way for the kids. Because the child will talk like a monkey. They just bring talk like a monkey. May the Lord help us. Brother and sister, sit with your child. Prophesy good things upon your child. Tell the child good things. We are staying in a very busy country. The children are brought up by the TVs. And the child watches a cartoon that's instead of crying. But there's a problem with that. Let me tell you that. Praise the Lord. Sometimes I was sleeping. And you're not supposed to sleep.
Charles, the door is open.
Charles, okay, I'm not going to
Charles, the door is open.
Okay, I'm not going to move here. I woke up. And I was looking at the door. And I found that the door was not closed. The door is not not open. The door is closed. And I went back on the seat and slept again. When I was sleeping. Now, this individual, how did I ignore this person? And I can see the door is closed. I'll go back there. I went back to his bed, to his room. He's just looking at the window. He didn't go back to bed.
Which door is open?
And he opened the curtain. And he pointed that thing.
And
before that, in my car, the door was open. The door of my car, not the house. Sometimes it's not good to ignore when someone speaks to you. And I went and closed the door of my car. I'm not brought up my children here. But I want to tell you that in the need of helping you, just help your children. You're going to get all the money that you need. You got double and triple. You spend a lot of money with your own children. You take your child back home, just have time with your own children. Prophesy good about your children. Praise the Lord. Amen. Able to see my message water. Tutaimba wimbo moja. Tuwe na nafasi njema kwenda mbele ya Bwana. And I want you to just to point your prayers to your own tongue. I want to be speaking good things. Things that are helpful. The things that can also help me. Abu tupatiwe wimbo moja na moja ambaye atatupea.
Nataka kufanana nawe, nataka kufanana nawe, nataka kufanana nawe, moyo wa
guponye,
nataka
kufanana nawe. Nataka kufanana nawe, nataka kufanana nawe, moyo wangu uponywe,
nataka kuguzwa na wewe,
nataka kuguzwa na wewe. Nataka kuguzwa na wewe, moyo wangu uponywe.
Nataka kuongozwa na wewe,
nataka kuongozwa na wewe,
nataka
kuongozwa na wewe. Yesu, karibu, karibu, Yesu, karibu, karibu, Yesu, karibu, moyo wangu ponye,
karibu,
Yesu, karibu,
Yesu,
karibu, Yesu, karibu,
Yesu,
karibu, Yesu, karibu, moyo wangu ponye.
Thank you, Father. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, yes, Father, thine wali twalia Jesu Kristo.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ,
we come
before you this time of the day, thanking you, Lord, and even telling you thank you again because of all the goodness and the good that you have done to us. You have been a blessing unto us, even given us great things since we came to this place. You have spoken unto us the way you wanted us to hear. That it has come a time, brother, of our Father, we let our tongue to think, to talk things that you know does not praise you. And if you have a seed that our bodies are temples of the Spirit, help us that the things that we talk with your own tongues, they shall be praising in your own ears. We repent every sin that has come from our tongues, the sins that have come as a result of our tongues. We pray that you help us, because so many things and so many homes have been consumed, so many have been scattered, even the church has become spoiled because of the tongue. So many people have run astray because of the tongue. We pray that you help us. Help us, Lord, so that we can stand. We honor you and even lift you high, seeing that you're good God and there's no other God like you. Amen.